Good evening, everyone. Welcome to another webinar discussion on OCP Media Network with Sofia, our good friend from Thessaloniki, Greece. Sofia is she's a mass media PhD student with the Aristotle University of Thessaloniki. And she's been working in the area of Orthodox media and journalism, you know, for quite some time. So today we will have a discussion with her on the nature of Orthodox Christian media and journalism in Greece. Welcome, Sophie.
Thank you very much, George, for the invitation. Hello, everyone. And it's my pleasure to meet you through internet again.
Yeah, thank you so much, Sophie, for accepting our invitation. So, let me ask you something, like as an introductory remark. Like, can you give us an overview of Christian media in Greece? Christian media. How do you operate with the Christian media, and what are the important aspects of Christian media in Greece?
Okay, it's a big issue, but I try to give a small introduction to make it clear for those who are watching us.
Yeah.
First of all, if we want to talk about the relationship of religion and the church with the media and the Christian media, mm-hmm. we must take into consideration the religious tradition and mm-hmm. the role of the church in Greece in this specific case. Okay. The culture of politics and politicians, the mm-hmm. type and content of public discourse, and finally the culture of journalists.
Okay.
In the case of Greece, the situation is a bit complex. Because the church plays an institutional role in Greek society and reserves the right to intervene in political and social issues. Mm-hmm. The events of the church are not private affairs, as is the case in other states. Mm-hmm. For its sake, the Greek state maintains binding links with the church. In mm-hmm. all Greek constitutions, it is recognized that the prevailing religion in Greek territory is the Eastern Orthodox Church of Christ. Mm-hmm. Let's begin with the mass media and especially the television. Here in Greece, we have three purely Orthodox Christian television stations. Mm-hmm. They are local stations in they broadcast one in Thessaloniki and in the north part of Greece. Mm-hmm. The other two is one in south Greece in Patra. It belongs to Metropolis of Patra, and the other is in the island of Rhodes, and it belongs to a big holy monastery of the island.
So let me ask you something in between. You told that we have three major television stations in Greece. Do you have a television station operated by the Archbishopric in Athens?
No, these three Orthodox television stations they don't belong to the official Church of Greece, to the Holy Synod.
Okay.
One television station belongs to the Holy Brotherhood of Saint Lydia here in Thessaloniki.
Okay.
The second one belongs to a metropolis, Metropolis of Patras, mm-hmm. and the third one belongs to a holy monastery of Island of Rhodes.
Oh, okay.
None of them belong to the Church of Greece.
So there is no central control of media from the Archbishopric in Athens, right?
Exactly. But the Church of Greece owns a radio station.
Oh, okay, I understand. So they are purely broadcasting religious Christian Orthodox news updates and programs, or are they into political and secular issues as well?
The first one, they program are two axes, Greek faith and Greek Orthodox tradition.
Okay.
They don't broadcast political issues, but sometimes they broadcast national issues and general issues like the relationship, the relationships between between the spouses, between the family, parents and children, and social issues.
Okay.
Drugs, let's say. Another thing that we have to underline is that many metropolis of the Church of Greece have their own radio stations, but
okay.
not so big as the radio station of Church of Greece.
Okay.
And the second biggest, let's could say that is the radio station of Metropolis of Piraeus.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Piraeke Ecclesia.
Mm-hmm.
And the third part is the internet.
Yeah, I understand. So like people in Greece, for us, especially the faithful, the Greek Orthodox Christians, they prefer like radio to television, or like they're more interested with, you know, listening to radio, or like do they have a preference, any sort of preference? Like,
I think that it depends. I think that they prefer both of them.
Okay. Okay.
The audience of these Orthodox media, even TV stations, even radio, are small, but the audience are dedicated and committed to these media.
Okay.
And they prefer to they watch them mainly for the broadcast of divine liturgies and services.
Oh, people, I understand that.
People who are ill, who cannot go to the church every Sunday or in the big feasts and to watch they prefer to watch the masses through TV or listening to them from the radio.
Okay, and for example, if you talk about the internet stations or the internet websites, we see a lot of independently run journalistic or internet news media websites. So do you have a lot in Greece, like these internet, independent internet portals, broadcasting church news and events?
We could say that we have few. Internet, it's easier to create a page, an internet page, or an internet portal with the news than to create a TV station or a radio station.
Okay.
So that's why we have few pages, few portals, let's say.
Okay.
With church and religion news.
Okay.
They are independent. They are. Some of them are consists of journalists.
Mm-hmm.
Some others are more not so professional with
okay,
not journalists.
I understand. And regarding this internet and this radio and TV stations, for example, they are satellite channels, right? That means if I want to watch them from India or from USA, can I watch them?
I think that you can watch them through internet because TV stations broadcast the same program through internet, and you can watch them through internet.
So that is the best way. Okay, that's the best way to reach them.
The best and the most the easiest way to expand your audience. Yeah. I'm not sure if the satellite program of one television station. One Orthodox television station who belongs to Saint Lydia Brotherhood can approach so many countries.
Okay, I understand.
I'm not,
Okay. Do they broadcast events and news in other languages like English, or they're just like restricted themselves to the Greece broadcasting? I mean, like they are just limited to the audience in Greece. Like they just aim at the audience in Greece, or do they have programs in English?
TV and radio stations from TV and radio stations that belongs to Metropolis or are church and Orthodox oriented have programs only on Greek language.
Okay,
but,
fine. Okay.
But some portals on the internet have news and in other languages, especially in English and Slavic
languages,
to contact with the majority of Orthodox people in Slavic countries.
Okay, I understand. Thank you.
At Orthodoxia.info, we have some news on Greek and on French.
Okay, and can you explain a little bit about Orthodoxia.info, your association with Orthodoxia.info, and the nature of your work?
Orthodoxia.info established 5 years, almost 5 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
We are a small but very dedicated team, and we love so much this job.
Mm-hmm.
We're all journalists and experienced in the field of reporting religion and reporting church affairs.
Mm-hmm.
And our goal is to be independent.
Mm-hmm. I understand
and
that.
Professional, to do independent and professional work.
Mm-hmm.
It's difficult to run an internet page in this time because we had for many years financial crisis. Now we have COVID, mm-hmm. COVID difficulties. But we try to do our best to have cross-checked and real news for our audience.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I understand that. And you basically associate with Orthodoxia.info as a journalist, right?
Yes. As a journalist, I cover the subjects, the issues from my region almost. But many times, general issues about religion, and sometimes when there are important things, we have news about Catholics, about Vatican City, about Pope, or about Muslims, because we have a Muslim community in Greece.
Okay. And do you, for example, from your side, from Orthodoxia.info, and from the part of other independent websites, and also from the side of the church-run radio and TV station, do they broadcast news and events on Oriental Orthodox Christians, on Protestants, on Anglicans, apart from the Vatican news and the Greek Orthodox news?
The TV and radio stations in Greece who are Orthodox, they focus on Orthodox news, on news that has to do with Orthodox tradition, Orthodox church.
Okay.
But we have a radio station from Evangelical Church,
mm-hmm.
from Pentecost Church that covers the news from their tradition.
Oh, okay, fine. The Orthodox portals, TV stations, they are just focusing on the Greek Orthodox affairs, right?
Yes, issues from Greek Orthodox Church, from Ecumenical Patriarchate, and the relations between the relations between patriarchates, but focus on Orthodox Church, yes.
Okay. Do they broadcast news and events from other Orthodox churches? For example, like Russian, Serbian, Bulgarian, Georgian. Do they broadcast such news events, news and events?
Not exactly events. For example, they have limited. I think that they have limited financial sources, and I think that they cannot do a lot of things. But the television station the television station 4E we have here in Thessaloniki, has traveled in other Orthodox countries and do documentaries in other Orthodox monasteries from these countries.
Oh, okay. So, for example, let me ask you another question. The Greek Orthodox Christians in the country, are they interested to know what is going around, around the Christian world? For example, what's happening in Egypt? For example, what's happening in Ethiopia? What's happening with other Christian churches and denominations? Are they really interested to know?
It's hard to say yes or no. I think that a few people are interested, but I'm not sure that the majority of people are so interested, because they focus on their problems.
Yeah, I understand that. Yeah,
when
right,
people
right.
have financial or social problems, or when there are problems in Orthodox Christianity, I think that people focus on themselves and on their family and the small environment, on the people they are near to them.
Yeah, I understand, Sofia. I understand, because they have more than issues, a lot of issues to focus. They have to run their family. They have to take care of their spiritual affairs. So mostly they are focused on their environment. You know, they are like limited. This is what you are trying to tell us, right?
Yes, yes. I think that there is a limited interest in other countries that we are so far from. From us.
Yeah, it's clear. And let me ask you, like, as a journalist, as an Orthodox Christian journalist, what are your challenges? What are the challenges that you encounter on daily basis, or what are your general challenges?
Generally, journalist is not an easy task, an easy job to do. You have to be informed every moment about what happens in your region, in your city, in your country. Not only about religious affairs, but general. You have to be informed generally. Sometimes church is a closed environment, and you have to be prepared to contact. You have to know to contact with people in church, with hierarchs. You have to know many things about the history of the church, about Orthodox tradition, about Orthodox faith, in order to be accurate in your reporting. You have to respect very much the people who are in church, who are the clergymen, the theologians, and you have to respect this kind of reporting, because faith and religion are very sensitive issues, and you have to be very careful and accurate about what you say, what you write, about how to communicate with people in these places.
Okay, now I have a difficult question for you, Sophie. For example, you told me that you have to be very respectful and you need to take care of the sensitive part of the church and people, the hierarchs, the bishops and all. So, for example, as an independent journalist, as an Orthodox Christian journalist, for example, you need to cover some sensitive issue, something that has gone wrong from the side of the church or from the clergy or from the bishops. How will you approach that sort of reporting?
The difficulty is not the question, but how to cover this issue.
Yeah.
You have to be very careful and accurate, and you have to show respect to the other profession. But you have to focus on your own values, on journalists' values.
Mm-hmm.
And to do your best to inform the audience,
mm-hmm.
but to protect the faith.
Yeah, right. So that comes as a prime concern for all journalists working in Greece, right? To protect the faith, to defend the church. To defend the hierarchy. So that's a major concern, if I am right.
Let's say that you have to do your job to be independent and to inform your audience without be offensive to anyone.
Yeah, it's, I understand. But the problem is that you cannot be, you cannot always report things, by like taking care of all aspects. Sometimes you need to be critical. Sometimes you need to be like a little bit critical.
Sometimes you have to be critical, and sometimes you have to be more critical than in some issues than others, but you have always to keep in mind not to be offensive to anyone and try to be respectful to everyone.
Yeah. Okay. And how?
It's a thick line. It's a thick line, and sometimes it's hard to say generalize. It depends on the case.
Okay. So what is the approach of the Church of Greece towards independent journalists like you? Like, do they motivate you? Like, do they communicate with you on a regular basis? Do they give you a space to operate? Because they are already running 3 TV stations. They have their own websites. But as an independent journalist, do you find it, easy to work with the church hierarchy?
I think that the church hierarchy and clergymen and all people that has to do with church mm-hmm. appreciate independent and independent journalists because they do serious they do their job seriously, and they don't spread fake news or yellow news or gossip and things like that. I think that it's a hard job. Sometimes it's difficult, but at the end of the day, we can communicate with hierarchs. We are in contact with them when we need some votes, when we need information, and they give us information because they appreciate journalists who don't spread fake news and who don't do gossip.
Okay, I understand. That's clear. So there's another question, again, a little bit difficult question, I believe. How do you actually raise funds for an independent Orthodox journalistic institution? For example, Orthodoxia.info. If you are permitted to share that, please do that. How do you find funds? Because you need to pay salaries to your journalist. You need to take care of other expenses. So what's the best way of raising funds in Greece?
It's It's difficult. It's very difficult to find funds. We try to do through web TV to broadcast services and divine liturgies. So we, in order to have a small fund for people who work for the site, we expand the section of web TV in order to afford the site.
Okay, it's like do you go for advertisements? For example, you go for advertisements, or you get personal fundings from someone, like someone who likes your work, they may donate. But you need to have a regular flow of fund to sustain your work and your institution, right?
We try to expand it. We try other sites have advertising. Mm-hmm. So they can afford salaries and things like that. And other sites have cooperation with, let's say, a shorter cooperation with metropolises or.
Okay. I understand that. So that's like a mutual support and cooperation that they work on to sustain forward, right?
But it's difficult, and due to the general financial situation in Greece, to fundraising and to afford to have a site, not only a religion site,
I understand. But one way or other, you survive, because one way or other, you need to move forward. You need to push forward with your work and with your, your institution, right?
We try because we love very much our job, and we love very much this kind of reporting.
So what I understand from your side is, like, it's all about passion. It's about passion that's leading you. More than the monetary aspects, more than the financial aspects. It's all about the passion to work as a journalist. Am I right?
Exactly.
Yeah. So you will, one way or the other, you will find some sources to move forward. Am I right?
We will see.
Yeah, of course. And for example, like if I'm an aspiring journalist, I want to do some studies in church journalism. Would you advise students to take up church journalism, Christian journalism, or religious journalism as a source of income or as their profession? Do you advise? If you advise, what are the challenges and scope for religious journalism in the context of Greece?
It's a challenge, but if a young person loves this kind of reporting and wants to be journalist and to do religion reporting, mm-hmm. I advise them to try. When you begin your career or your studies, you are not sure about the future, but you can try, and I think that it's the best for yourself. It's the best thing that you can do for yourself, a young person, to try to read very much about religion issues and Orthodox tradition, to study theology. It would be very helpful, and to try.
What you're trying to say is, like, in order to be a journalist, an Orthodox Christian journalist or religious journalist, you need to build base right from the beginning. Am I right?
Yes, it's very helpful if you build step by step your path. it's mm-hmm. better and it's easier for your future.
Okay. Can you tell me something about your PhD program with Aristotle University of Thessaloniki? Because you're doing your PhD program in mass media, right?
Yes, I have a bachelor and master from Department of Journalism from Aristotle University, and I do my PhD on the section of chartered media. So I'm occupied with this issue, not only from journalistic and journalistic option, but for academic reasons as well. It's not an easy issue because it's a session that there are not it not it has not been studied in Greece.
Okay.
So we don't have a bibliography.
Okay, I understand.
But okay. With an associate professor from University of Macedonia here in Thessaloniki, we try to make this bibliography happen.
So that's an interesting case because since this is still a new area, like church, mass media, and journalism is still a new area, right? This is what you are trying to tell us, right?
It's a new starting area in Greece because academics don't study it so much, and we try to study it and to have some papers and some articles, academic articles about this field.
And maybe you are one of the pioneers in this field who is pursuing a PhD program in Aristotle University of Thessaloniki, right?
I don't think so. I would like to be, but I don't think that it's so pioneering. But yeah. We try to.
Yeah, I think, but do you have other students working in this area, at least doing their masters or doing their research in the same area that you are working with?
I think that in the Department of Journalism, there is no other to study this field of church, to combine the field of church, theology, religion with media. There are some studies from theology department, but they see this field from theologian aspect, from theologian
okay.
option. So we try to combine.
Okay, I understand. And do you have like priests and deacons or nuns who are working in the area of Orthodox mass media and journalism? Do you see that they have shown some kind of interest to work? I mean, from
yes.
the Church of the Greece.
Yes, we have the radio stations in Greece, which belong to metropolises.
Mm-hmm.
They have priests for their programs, and mm-hmm. The TV station that belongs to the monastery has mm-hmm. programs with its abbot, I think, with the abbot of monastery.
Okay, so that means the staff and the program makers of such TV units they are from the church, like nuns. Priest and the deacons, right?
Yes.
Okay. And for example, let's take the case of old calendar Greek Orthodox churches. I mean, those churches who are separated from the Church of Greece.
Mm.
How are they into such kind of journalism? Because I see a lot of websites run by the old calendar groups. But what is their presence in the media in Greece? Because they are minority, you know, in comparison to the Church of Greece. But still, they try a lot from their side to push a lot through media, especially through the internet.
They don't have their own TV or radio station. Just
okay.
just blogs, I think.
Yeah.
I think they don't try to. they don't try to have more powerful presence in the media, but in some local in some local TV stations, some priests of the old calendar do programs, do talk shows.
Oh, okay, okay, I understand that.
So, in generally speaking, their presence is very limited.
Yeah, that's one reason. Maybe that's one reason that they are very limited to, you know, some newspapers or some like very few internet websites and all, right?
Yes.
Okay. And can you tell us a little bit about your association with IARJ, International Association of
Member? I'm a member of this association because I attended the first seminar of Thomson Reuters Foundation at 2015, yes, in London, about reporting religion, and and all the attendants after the seminar, we became members of these associations. It was a very interesting seminar which broadens our horizons in this field, because we were a small group from the over the world, from many doctrines, and the association is a big association that in USA, I think, it has members in all over the world. It has a very interesting site and gives opportunities to religion reporters in all over the world to send issues, articles, and to have communication with other journalists like us in other countries to help each other.
Okay. Do you have this is also another difficult question. Do you face censorship with media journalism, church media journalism in your country?
Personally, if I have a personal example or general speaking?
In general.
I think that there is no censorship. There is no censorship in this media, but they have a specific orientation. So the programs they broadcast follow this orientation, but no censorship.
I understand. And do you associate with, I mean, the media groups in Greece, do they associate with the media groups in Cyprus? For example, the Church of Cyprus, they have their own TV station, their own blogs. Do you have any sort of association? Because of your intense relationship with between the two countries, do you have any such kind of association with the Church of Cyprus?
As far as I know, the television station who belongs in St. Lydia Brotherhood had association with church media in Cyprus, but I'm not sure for now.
Okay, and do you have any associations with the diaspora media groups? For example, we have a Greek Orthodox media functioning from the US, in Australia, in other parts of Europe. So do you try to communicate with them or form some kind of associations with them?
I don't think on official level, but there is an exchange of information when this media have information and news about local Orthodox issues. We take information from them. When we have news about important issues in Greece, they take information and news from us. There is exchange of information and exchange of news.
And do you have, for example, do you have an association for the Greek Orthodox journalists in your country? Some kind of associations like International Association of Religious Report, you have an association for the Greek Orthodox journalists in Greece or the media groups in Greece?
No, there is no specific association for religion reporters, journalists in Greece. There are two main general associations of journalists. Mm-hmm. One in Athens and one in Greece. One in Athens and one in Thessaloniki and North Greece, but not a specific organization or association or organization for church journalists or religion journalists.
Do you recommend such kind of associations? For example, if you start such kind of associations, will it help your work to get it in a more organized manner, or will it help the journalist and as well as the churches? Do you think so?
Maybe it would be helpful, but Greece is a small country, and the journalists who are occupied with church issues and religious issues are limited. So I don't know if it could be sustainable such an association.
Okay, I understand that. And can you tell us a little bit?
We are few, and in many cases we know each other. And I don't know if it could be sustainable.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay. Can you tell us a little bit about the media coverage on Mount Athos, the monastic republic of Mount Athos? Do they have their own TV or stations? But they run a lot of websites, I know that. But how do they, bring up the information, and how do they distribute the information to the outer world?
There are many sites that have news and issues about Mount Athos, because it's such a specific holy place, not only in Greece, in all over the world.
Yes, you're right. Right.
Mount Athos. I think that the Holy Monastery of Atopedi has a website.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have a website. They have one or two websites, by the way, right?
Yes, and the new one, biggest one, with news from all over the Orthodox world.
Okay.
Not only from Mount Athos, and I think they try to expand these sites to enrich them with issues and news.
Okay, and an interesting thing that I found in recent times is many of the Greek Orthodox media, whether it be a website, blogs, they've been trying to communicate or broadcast news in English. So this has, I've noticed this as a new trend, because we have a lot of, developments in the area of mass media and social media platforms. I think many of the groups, they're trying to broadcast news items in English. So do you think that in future this will be helpful for, your work?
I don't know. We will see it. But in recent years, we have many people from abroad. We have many, many, many refugees. And immigrants, so it's logical to have news in other language to communicate with people, to inform these people who are Christians.
Some
of them are Christians, I think that this trend. Maybe it has to do with the try to to expand the audience and in other countries, because there are Greek Orthodox people in many other countries.
Yeah, right. I understand that. Personally speaking, it was one of the most challenging assignments in your career so far. What was one of the most challenging assignments as an Orthodox Christian journalist?
It's hard to say. I think that the big challenge was when we started the site. Yes, when we started the site, the period we needed to find the way to communicate with church, to make our job known to people, to gain their appreciate and their faith.
Mm-hmm. I understand that. So it was actually a challenge for you to build the whole website, the whole portal, right? The whole process.
Yes, and but it's very interesting. This let's say this trip is very interesting, and I remember the first time that I was sent to cover a meeting from Archbishop of Athens with the Minister of Education. It was a challenge for me because it was the first time to cover such an important issue with political aspects, but you gain experience for these things.
And if I'm right, you also had a session with His All Holiness Ecumenical Patriarch, right? Am I right? Did you have a session with the Ecumenical Patriarch?
I followed the Ecumenical Patriarch during his visit in a town near Thessaloniki.
Okay.
And we had some small meetings to inform us, and the big challenge was when I cover with our director of the site, mm-hmm. the big synod in Crete.
Mm-hmm.
This was a difficult challenge.
Okay, I understand. And Sophie, one last question from my side. As a female journalist, do you face any sort of difficulties or limitations? Because you need to travel a lot, you need to meet a lot of people. So do you face such difficulties as a female Orthodox Christian journalist, as a woman?
I face the difficulties that every woman who works in such a profession, such a job, mm-hmm. faces. Sometimes it's difficult to combine your work, your family, your studies, but you have to try harder than sometimes you have to try harder than a man, but it's okay. Mm-hmm. A difficulty in our job is that I cannot travel to Mount Athos.
I understand that you can't travel. No women can travel.
It's a limitation that I cannot visit Mount Athos, it's okay. There are many colleagues who can travel, and it's okay. Sometimes you have to try harder to gain the loyalty.
Yeah, from, I understand. Yeah,
from people in church. Mm-hmm. you have to persuade them to gain confidence.
Mm-hmm.
But generally speaking, it's okay.
It's fine. Okay. Thank you so much, Sophie, for all those answers. Like, what made you choose a career in Orthodox Christian journalism? Was it your decision, or did someone guide you?
Let me think. When I was a child, I wanted to become a journalist when I was a child.
Oh.
And I come from a faithful family.
Okay.
With relations with church.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that I was more keen to all this world. I had from a child a relationship with church, with faith, with people in church, and I was very familiar with all these things. And I think that it was easier for me to follow. I didn't imagine that I will follow this kind of reportage when I graduated from university, but I found my first job in one of these three TV stations oriented in church, and it was easier for me to follow this way. But I think that the life brought it to me.
Sophie, we'll conclude the session with one final. Yeah, we'll conclude the session with one final question. Do you have more women? Do you have more women in Greece, in your country, who is interested to take up a career in religious reporting or religious journalism?
I think that there are more women than men in this field.
And
women are so women are very good at this, and they do important careers.
Okay, so that means you think that women are more. I mean. Women are performing better in this area, right? And they are more interested to take up careers in the field of Christian.
No, I don't think so. It hasn't to do with the gender. I don't think so.
Okay.
It happens.
Okay, I understand that.
Just happens.
Okay, thank you so much. I hope we are fine with the sessions, and there is no more questions. So I would like to thank you for accepting our invitation for this brief webinar discussion on the aspects of religious and Christian Orthodox journalism and media in Greece. And thank you so much, Sophie, for accepting our invitation. And thank you so much for spending some time with us. And from the part of the OCP family, I take this opportunity to convey our gratitude, and we also wish you the very best for your future endeavors.
Thank you very, very much, and I hope you all the best.
Thank you so much, Sophie. Thank you.
Thank you.
And stay safe. And thank you so much. Bye bye.